Ballistics Masters here. I'm Just Harry, of course, joined by my caster friend. It's Hugo TV, or just Hugo, if you know my name like I do. So, you know, today we're going to be seeing Millwall Bushwhackers versus UCGL. This is going to be the second map. This is Millwall's pick as well, and it is going to be cash. We've already had the knife round. Millwall did take that, and they've opted to go for the T side by the looks of things. So, we're going to be seeing them going out to the A site here. Bomb's going to go down nice and early on in the round. They are playing for the retakes here, so we have got UCGL rotating their players in slowly but surely. It's going to come down to if they can get these players onto the side fast enough. But Shang doing a great job of keeping these two players in a main at bar, but Rev are not going to allow that to happen for much longer. He does find the headshot onto Shang here. Thomas gets one. Can he make it two? He makes it two for his trouble. He's trying to go for the third, but he does get taken down by Spat. Wong putting this into a two versus one here as he gets that kill on a Rev, and now Spat trying to land this shot, probably the easiest shot of his life, and he just misses it. He must be kicking himself in the teeth after missing that shot, and that time is just going to keep on ticking. He has got the defuse kit now, so he could get on this, but he might get knocked here. Prezi just manages to mess that up, and he dances on his head for a little bit. And Wong just coming in to be the savior of it all, landing that headshot with the P250 and locking in the first round for Millwall Bushwhackers.
Yeah, obviously, Millwall picking this T side isn't really a surprise. They had a very dominating start, and when you're against a team, a lesser team that you think you can just tear apart, you do want to start on the T side just to kind of control the pace, because obviously if you're on the CT side, you're holding for the pushes, you're going to be waiting out long times. But if you're on the T side and you want it to be a fast game, you can make it a fast game. You control the pace of the match, so you can just go for these rushes and you can just go for the really aggressive plays that just finish up the rounds very, very quickly. And that's going to be the mode to do really for Millwall, because you can see they're obviously performing very well at the moment. And Spat is going to get one kill though, at least from the CT side, but by and large Millwall are just cleaning up.
Yeah, you know, I mean, going to be 4 versus 2, and they've got rifles, whereas looking over at UCGL, they have decided to full-on eco this round, so they might be going for some weird third round buy. We'll be curious to see what goes on there. We did see a few players buy up in the form of Hawk and Mansuas, and, you know, only Mansuas left alive now, so, as one of those bought-up players, Rev all the way over on A, of course, he's going to be saving to get that AWP, and him holding position here might not be a bad thing. The rotate should be coming at any point soon from Mansuas, because, you know, with no contestion over on B, it should be obvious the bomb's going to be heading over towards A. The rotate is coming in. Maybe it's too little too late, though. It's going to be down to Rev here with this UFP to hold off the site. Does do a little bit of damage, but Shank's going to find him. And now it's all down to Mansuas here with that 5-7 he invested so heavily into to clutch this 1 versus 4. And personally, I don't see that happening.
No, unlikely, especially with a lack of armor. And Prezi with a MAC-10, obviously the aimbot gun there, it's just going to finish him off. Mill will take 2 rounds in a row now. And UCGL, they're going to be on the the eco once again, it seems. Mansuas just going straight for the deagle, not going to be going for the buy-up, of course. Getting that double full eco in there, which is really interesting to see. You don't see that a lot, but it allows you to get a plentiful amount of nades on the fourth round, as well as occasionally an AWP if you have one player standing out, getting a few kills to rack up those $300 bonuses. So it's understandable why they've done it, but you don't see it too often, is all.
Yeah, no, I mean, I do agree. Rev starting the round off with a very nice kill there on the Prezi, so that's going to mean it's a 4 versus 5 here. They might be able to get that gun, but it does seem unlikely, as we have got the ever so watchful eyes of, I believe that's going to be Shanked, just watching over that weapon. Thomas opening up onto the A site, does find one. Now we're going to see Waggle, he's going to be inside the smoke, just waiting for this bomb to go down. They do sneak past him, they're not going to check it, just move away. He finds one, can he make it two? Thomas, though, with the return kill, is going to put this now into a 1 versus 3. It's all going to be on Rev with that glorious USP. Aimbot gun, though, going to get the better of him, getting those headshots, even though he was 8 kilometers away, and not even a US-trained army sniper could have ever landed that shot. You know, when you've got a MAC-10 in your pocket, who cares? So we're going to be seeing Rev now picking up the AWP for UCGL. Shanked as well over on Millwall is going to be AWPing, which is a little bit peculiar, because I would say, you know, Wong, we've seen do so well with that AWP, and I say this every time, but they just seem to not want to give it to him, maybe because they don't want to unleash the beast just yet.
Well, Shanked has been doing work with the AWP as well in the previous map. We did see them both pick it up from time to time, and it wasn't even that they would double AWP and Shanked would pick it up with Wong. Sometimes Shanked had it, sometimes Wong had it. It usually just depended off the spawn, and then they just kept it for the whole round there. So a bit of a change, but either way, really, we're going to see the first kill come out in the favour of Spat. UCGL definitely needed that as he drops Wong. Their lack of an AWP means his death is imminent, and Spat's death is imminent too as Shank drops him over towards B. But that's the refrag they needed right now, and Millwall just split up here. They're playing the buddy system, which I like to see. I'm a big fan of the buddy system. Two players putting themselves together, sorry, and allowing themselves to play for trades. So one of them, you know, taking map control, the other one trading if they do fall down. So of course that is a good way to play, but right now they're going to be splitting up. Shanked getting the bomb and heading back towards the A site. Prezzy just going to be the luck to create a distraction, and three of the players going over towards A right now to find that challenger. And Michael, he's going to be the one to fight this out. Peeks very aggressively into it. Picks up two kills instantly. Shanked and Velox, they're going to fall. Rev also grabs one as well. And Lancers will finish one up onto Thomas there. So UCGL taking that first buy round on the board there with a very effective start.
Yeah, they did need that round, so they did manage to secure it, which is going to be good. That's going to kind of take the rug out from underneath Millwall's feet now. And they will be forced onto a little bit of a force, but they've got that Tech-9 on Wong. But other than that, you know, plenty of rifles between everyone, a good bit of utility, maybe not as much as they'd need when you compare it to UCGL, who have got a bounty more. We're going to see a very aggressive push out mid, and maybe that's going to be the death of them here, as Hawk does great damage with Spat to back him up. They do manage to find two, though. Prezzy gets one of his own, and he's looking for a third, but unable to do it. Hawk does take down Thomas there now. Backup does come in the form of Mantua, who's on from Highway. So that's going to be 2 versus 4 here. And we're seeing the rotate coming in from Wong. It's going to be a very mid-focused battle here as the bomb is down. That smoke, though, should allow Wong to go in and pick it up, but he's going to be opting to go back up his boy Prezzy in mid.
UCGL still challenging the situation. They have no need to. They could just play passive and do absolutely fine there, and still deciding to go for these peaks. We're finally going to realize, you can see both players are going to back off of Highway and of Z there, and then they will come in doing a lot of damage onto Prezzy and Wong, both down to quite low HP here. And you can see now Millwall trying to take map control, but UCGL aren't allowing them any picks, so that's completely shutting down any kind of push coming out from this T side, which is going to make it extremely difficult to do too much. And Hawk, he's going to be rotating in through Z, so maybe he could do something crazy, like jump through the smoke here. That's always possible, as we do see one player running very close. That's Wong, hits that shot there. Mantua meanwhile will drop his dead teammate next to him, but he's going to take two as well. So UCGL, they're going to be up on 2 rounds now to 3. But off into the 6th round here, Millwall just going to be going for the deco. 4 deagles to buy up out of PT50 on Shanked, because he likes to ruin parties. He likes to stomp on kids' birthday cakes, so he doesn't want to go for the 5-man deagle play. To be fair, he doesn't have any money to work with either, so that's understandable here. And Waggle going to be holding off towards the back of fence. Shanked, he's pushed himself up in towards A, over towards the boost shroud spot, or toxic, depending on what you like to call it there. There are 3 toxics on this map, so I think it needs a more original name, but he is up on boost. Meanwhile, we're going to see a bit of a flank coming out from Hawk. He's going to drop Thomas as he gets aggressive towards mid, and right now UCGL are going to be allowed to get aggressive because these pistols are not going to be too great. But Wong, he is great. He's going to be dropping Waggle over towards A, and Mansour's, he's going to answer into Shanked, but Wong, he's getting a double on D, because why the hell not? Back into a 3v3. Favourable still to UCGL, because the time is ticking away, and Hawk picks up another one over into middle as the rotation comes out back towards EA site, and Wong and Pezzy are left alive as the last two both split up. They won't be able to trade in these positions, and the bomb will be going back in towards mid, it seems. But Wong's just going to be allowed.
It's going to be on Prezzy here. It's looking like an A push, and you know, if he checks uppers here, he could potentially find this kill on a Hawk. Hopefully he does. Hawk being 13 HP and Prezzy having this deagle should make it an easy kill, but he's not going to check it. And that will be the 3rd round going the way of UCGL there.
Good round indeed. And now I'm going to be seeing the buy-up from both teams. No AWP in play on the Terra side, but Revs decided to get one here for the CTs, just to work with over towards the B side, just spotting out for a bit of a preemptive push. And, oh, great shot through the smoke. Prezzy's going to fall, and that's going to be the pick already. But, oh, no, UCGL, they're doing this again. Double boost up on towards the A site. Shank's going to deny it, though. Shot through the smoke will drop Hawk, but they still manage to boost up both Mantua's and Waggle up here. So this is a really, really good play. And of course, they only have to spot out one player, and they're not going to know that there's going to be two on this boost spot. So that's always really fun to see. I really love this position. I'm just waiting for Millwall to push out to this A site, because it will be a lot of fun to see UCGL try and challenge this. Because what happens if they kill or see the first person drop down, they think the spot's clear. And then See, so Velox just killed Mansworth. Now he thinks boost is clear, but Wackle is still up there, and he's just going to allow Thomas to push towards the back of the site, waiting for Velox to push out. Oh no, this is brilliant play. There's still one more coming from Main. I'm not sure if he's going to be ready for this. Picks up the first one to Velox, but there's still Shank to deal with, and he's going to get the trade frag. That was so much potential, but he just threw it away, Wackle there. Unlucky there. Now it's down to a 2v3. You can see even Velox is confused in chat. And the bomb will be going down over towards EA site. Great wall bang shot. One will get the return kill, and now it's all on Spat.
One versus two here as Spat does push out on the highway. He finds that first kill on the Wong, and now he's just got to find Shank in order to get this defuse. He's playing this very, very well, and he manages to get it with a sensational flick shot. That there is going to lock in the fourth round, going the way of UCGL, and it looks so sure. Millwall were going to take that, but just at the last minute, clutched out from underneath them. It is going to be UCGL taking the fourth round. It's going to go to 4-3 now. I mean, I'm going to be seeing Millwall pushed onto a very, very, kind of forced buy up here if they do decide to buy, which they probably should do. They're going to be opting for a Tech 9 buy just in order, I reckon, to get that utility. Maybe it's a really unusual buy. Look at it. They had enough to buy rifles, everyone, with exactly this much utility anyway, but they decided to opt for the Tech 9s, I guess, to go for the rush. Revler does find one with a little bit of collateral damage that he finds too. Does get taken out by one there. Now Spat picks up two of his own. Can he make it three? He can indeed, and that's going to be the fifth round going towards UCGL. Not too sure what that buy-up was about as well, but I mean, now they do have plenty of money, at least, in the bank account from the lost round bonus. We are finally going to be seeing Wong picking up an AWP to counter Rev the vape trade.
Love that little reference there, but Wong going to be heading over towards B for a change to the AWP, up to challenge Rev, and oh no, I shot this game. I'm not going to even, Harry won't get that reference, and there's no viewers, so it doesn't matter, but still, Wong trying to get that pick onto B, literally zooms out at the wrong time, and Rev gets away with that with his life. Mansus and Waggle are going to be doing work over towards A. Prezi will get a return kill onto Waggle, but Thomas is also jumping in with one of his own. We're into a 3v3 here. AWP still on either side, and they're both on full HP, but we can see Millwall going to be maybe bring this bomb back towards the B site as Thomas goes for this rotation. Prezi following in suite as well, and seems like it's going to be some kind of B play, but right now they just seem unsure. Thomas and Prezi maybe going back towards the A site. I really don't know what's happening right now. They seem to be very unsure. Going for this boost instead to get some mid control.
Yeah, I feel like the biggest danger right now to Millwall is that they're going to start to lose their confidence as they start to lose these rounds. And, confidence, I'd say, is one of the biggest detriments to success when it comes down to CS. So, very important that they keep on top of the morale here. With Hawk and Vents as well, this could be a tilting point here if Wong doesn't manage to spot this one out. Bomb is going to be heading over towards B, and it's all down to Hawk here to hold this off 1v2.
Oh, but they're not going to check this area, and he's going to be able to find that easy first kill to Wong. Peace out into middle as well, and Prezi, he's going to get the better of him as he shuts him down over towards the vent. 2v2 now, and they're going to make their way onto the site, but Rev, he's denying every single damn day. Thomas going to get dropped there over in CT spawn, and Prezi receiving a nice big white flash to the face. It's going to mean that he can't see a thing. Grabs the bomb though, and he might be able to make his way towards the site, but oh no, what's he doing? He way too late on that plan. He had time, but he just seems to be watching up or waiting for some aggression, but he's not going to get two kills in that 5 seconds there, so a bit of a misplay on him there.
Indeed, and it is going to be a buy coming out now from both teams as we do see a deagle being picked up on Prezi though over on the T side, which is curious considering that Shank, I thought Shank could drop it, but no, never mind, no one has any money. We have got the AWP once again on Rev, so lots of potential there. He's been doing extremely well this game.
A 4v5 is already established, and Prezi down on this deagle with no armor as well. It's clear that he's dropped a rifle for someone else, of course, so a bit of an issue there with his economy. But off we go. The A push is underway here, just running straight out onto the site. V looks to open things up with a nice goal to Wagglebands. Whereas he's going to be getting all the answers as he gets one onto Thomas for Shank. He's going to shank him back with a double kill. Hawk and Mansour is going to be dropped, and Spat and Rev are left to rotate into this mess of a site. Bomb will be going down here. Bit of a boost over towards the top of quad. And oh, Rev zooming out at the wrong time. Will be going for the re-peak, but they're not going to be challenging him anymore. And Spat still got a lot to do here. They have a double molly to work with. So right now, they could just force these players out of the quad area. It could be two easy kills as long as they clear Velox from default. But oh, the molly's going to be used over to there instead. And the thing is, he puts down the molly, but he doesn't peek with it. So he has no idea that Velox has moved out from the site, which is a bit of an issue there. Rev, he's going to be challenged in this last one. Does pick up the boost player on site. Shanked and Prezi both going down. They're great clutch by him. But at the end of the day, what a misplay there from Spat. Dropping out that molly onto the site and not peeking Velox as he moved away. A bit too late. But either way, he's still got the kill. But it was kind of just like, they shouldn't have let him get away with that from Millwall. Either way, UCGL dominating CT side. I question Mill's T side pick right now because it's not going too well for them.
Yeah, not at all. And as we have seen in the past, UCGL famously quite weak on their T side. So a strong CT side straight off the bat would be very good for them. Rev opening things up with a kill on a Velox. Now it's going to be a 4 versus 5 here. The deep push out of the site. Flash is going in. It's going to be very, very aggression. Lots of aggression coming in. Very aggressive, either one. But not going to find any kills there. Spat and Rev still managing to hold off this site. Pretty much uncontested. Good 99. Damage on the both for them, but no kills are going to come to fruition from that. You can't help but feel sorry there for Millwall.
Prezi just did 99 damage to Hawk.
Yeah, I know. And then as they pushed the site as well, Rev got hit down on like 12 HP. But they just couldn't make the shots connect.
But off we go, 12th round here, and we do see an AWP up on Thomas instead of Wong for a change there. It's not based off spawns, because he's just getting boosted up very slowly, so interesting there to see the change in AWP here. Thomas, not standing out significantly. Everyone's doing quite averagely on the Millwall side. Of course, they are only on 3 rounds, so you can't expect too much from them, but either way, not a whole lot on them here.
Yeah. Losing 8 rounds in a row is not going to be good for the morale. Millwall here just getting absolutely molested as they try their hardest to push out in mid through these smokes. It's going to be Hawk, he's going to be in mid, and he does try to do a little bit of damage through the smoke. Doesn't manage to find anyone just yet though, and mid control does get the way of Millwall here. Good bit of damage there done with that one by Thomas through that wall, and we are seeing Hawk take down a 9 HP. Doesn't manage to get a follow-up shot though onto Spat. It's going to be 2 players over towards A with just Hawk. And I'm not sure. Hawk and Rev combined HP of 22. That's what I was trying to figure out. Bad at maths on the fly.
Well, now about you. They got a combined HP of 22. Great sign.
Yeah.
He's so happy about that one. One gets taken down though, over towards Carr and Rev. Trying to hit through the shot through the smoke, but he won't be able to do so. Thomas still joining this team over towards the site. It should be doable though. A nade would be nice just to pick up this final kill onto Rev, but it's not going to matter because Thomas will drop Hawk there over in Vents. He's low anyway, down to 9 HP. But either way, Rev and Waggle last two alive here for the CT side, and the smoke will finally dissipate in CT spawn. This is going to allow them to, well, not push in, but escape from the area. I'm not sure why they waited till after the smoke there. Taking a huge risk, but either way, UCGL actually going to be losing a round for a change. They've won the last 8 in a row, and finally they're going to be thwarted as Mill will take control of the B site, and the save will be into action.
Yeah, Rev just wanted to cling to this AWP like Gollum to a ring, so he's going to be looking to hold that all the way over on A. And Millwall not wanting to take any chances going for the hunt here. Exit in together, live together, die together, farm together. Farming Simulator 2015. They're going to be getting out of there as best they can with those guns. They're going to take them into the next round. So, that's all good. No one to take any risks. I'm a fan of that when, your economy is this fragile and UCGL is so far ahead. They are just going to be looking to hold on to everything that they can. Rev does save that AWP, though, and that's going to give them a lot of leeway going into this next round. As we have seen, he's been very, very dominant with that rifle. And he's going to be taking it over towards the B site. Not going to be able to find anyone as the mid push does come out here from Millwall. Hawk finding one in mid, does get traded out by Shank, though. Good trade there. Batload, nice nade coming in. Mansour is in with the rotate as well from A. Going to be doing good damage in the middle. Waggle finds one of his own over on A. That's been Prezi going down. Another bomb in mid. And just Thomas left alive with this AWP. I can't help but feel like he must feel a little bit like the boy in striped pajamas at this point, if you've ever seen that film.
Oh my god, Harry.
No. I just mean like... because he is truly alone. I just picked a random film. Yeah. Thomas, though, with this AWP, trying to look in the mid, doesn't manage to find any heads. Be blown off just yet. Exactly like, I don't know, Tom Hanks and Saving Private Ryan. Trying to take mid control with this AWP. Just a one-man army hit. Not much is going to be happening. Like 40 seconds left on the clock. He does get that bomb, which is going to be good. Smoke coming out into Z, and he's going to be heading up towards the A site. He's actually going for this. He does do that flash, which almost blinds Waggle, but not today, as Waggle lands that headshot over the box. That's going to be Thomas going down. And that is going to be the ninth round going the way of UCGL. So UCGL back on top of things. They do manage to reset the economy of Millwall as well. And this is going to put Millwall in a very, very bad place. Indeed, still though, 9-4, not terrible. If they can finish this out at 10-5, I would say Millwall could take this and go into the next, you know, going into the second half, be able to come back from things. Seeing as UCGL have had, in all honesty, a very, very poor time at it on the T side.
Definitely so. But a bit of B-Rush is going to be the doctor's prescription for today. So get ready to go for this full B-stack here. All five players ready and waiting, apart from Prezi. He's going to be backing off to hold the flank. And here we go, Rev to find the first engagement. We'll hit the first shot. Not going to be able to grab a kill, but Spat, he takes two. And he must be watching Strictly Come Dancing there. Still rushing in through headshot. Shang just going to be holding the wrong angle. And that's going to allow Rev to grab that single kill. And Wong actually to get the bomb plant on the site. But right now, UCGL looking to take a 10th as they force him out of position with the Molotov. And he's going to be playing this quite well. But Waggle playing it better. Shuts him down there. And UCGL, they take 10-5 in that first half.
Yeah, you know, I mean, I don't know who it came down to at the end there. I think it was, I don't know. I mean, I want to say Velox, but I don't think it was. But still, I don't know. Like, I don't know, I was trying to come up with something funny, but still can't manage to do it. Comedy, not my forte. We only seeing now just rifles all around for Millwall and over on UCGL. They have got that AWP still on Rev. He's been doing phenomenally with that. He's going to be taking his AWP, minding his business. He's going to be taking that over to B, playing the B position. We only seen a boost coming out here from Millwall. Counter booster coming in. Hawk's going to be boosting up, and they're going to meet in the middle. Does manage to take him down. That's going to be Hawk taking out Prezi. Now it's a 4 versus 5 here, but looks like the HQ, it may as well be like a 3 versus, I don't know, like a few hundred. Millwall really struggling. Does manage to push through the Molotov there. Thomas, good nade, good damage. 7 HP getting that bomb down. You can't help but feel bad for him. I mean, I don't even know that nade come, didn't even blow up on my screen. So, you know, silent nades. I don't know if you've ever seen the film, what is it, 200 hours or something? Where the guy gets his hand stuck in a rock?
127 hours.
Yeah, I can't help but feel like that's how Thomas felt then.
Yeah, definitely, Harry. But I choked last round and thought that was the half because I wasn't thinking. But 11-4 is going to be the half, in fact. And UCGL, after we criticise them on the first map for only getting 4 rounds, it looks like they're doing, well, how many rounds did they get the first map?
What do you mean? Wait, what team?
How many rounds did UCGL get in the first map?
I believe they got to like 8.
Yeah, after we criticised UCGL for struggling in the first map, seems like they're forcing Millwall to do exactly the same thing here on Cash. So everyone's map picks are backwards today, which is fun.
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, going into this, very, very high expectations for Millwall, seeing as this is their map choice. Things have just been turned around, though. And the teams, you know, that we thought were going to do well on the maps that they picked, clearly haven't. And I know it's just like an underdog's day today, which is all good. Just like the Disney movie Underdog, if you haven't seen that, I'd highly recommend it. It's the one about a beagle. So there we go. Let me readying up. We should be going in. We've just got one AFK. He's just chilling out. So let's get some post-game analysis going on. Hugo, looking at, you know, their recent performances, how do you think the teams did on you know, on this?
I'm gonna go with UCGL did well. Millwall not so well.
Yeah, there you go, that's the analysis. Richard Lewis also joining us today. That was him just then, Hugo reading his words. Here we go. Going into the next round, 11-4. UCGL now on the T side. Famously, their weakest side. And I say famously, I mean, famously within this league, it is going to be their weakest side. Millwall on the CT side. Something that we've seen them do really well on Cash. So big things hopefully coming out from there. Yeah. It's looking like it's going to be a B side play. All four of them stacked up here.
But the thing is right now is you can't count Millwall out. Despite only having four rounds, they are still definitely competitive to win this. And we're going to see Shanked. He's going to face a first engagement over towards B. Thomas with a really nice position, but the vent split is going to come into play. Shanked hits one, but Thomas is still doing some serious work here. He grabs another one and still yet to receive any damage from this very aggressive position. The rotation is already coming out back towards A, and you can see Millwall are going to be reacting in time. Prezi, Velox, and Wong and Thomas all rotating over towards A, which is going to be a good call. But maybe too little too late, as UCGL, they make their way out on top of the site. Hawk going to be leading it. Spat tries to get the bomb down, but Velox denying that shot from the upper position. Picking up two headshots as well. Going for the third, he gets it. Velox, what a phenomenal play there on that pistol round to secure Millwall the five rounds.
Yeah, what a play there. Velox does pick up three. That's going to lock in the UAV for his team. He's going to be hoping to get the attack chopper in the coming rounds. Just going to need four more kills together. Going into this round, we ought to be seeing the Millwall they put up. Why did that make me laugh so much?
What? I didn't hear it. What made you laugh?
Almost holy hand grenade in mid. Does get four. He's going to go for the ace. Can he make it happen? It looks like he might get taken down here. He's going for the knife.
Yeah.
Oh, it truly is a UK event when the knives get bought out. There we go. It's going to be Thomas taking down the spat.
But all of his guns, have you noticed? So all of Thomas's guns are covered in flip sides.
Yeah, dude.
His M4, Thomas. His pistol. He really loves Flipside.
Yeah, no, I love Flipside. I agree with him there. It is going to be just a full eco throw around coming out from UCGL here. Millwall getting some rounds back on the board. Really standing a chance of getting back into this. They can take it to 7-11 here and not the American store. Here we go. Thomas and Prezi holding down this A-side takers. UCGL just walking into the meat grinder like lambs to the slaughter. They're going to go down, and that's going to be 11-7. That round literally took 25 seconds of my life, and what an amazing, gut-wrenching 25 seconds that was.
Oh, dearie, dearie me. But either way, Millwall, they're making slow progress back into the game. So as we were saying, they were doing pretty terribly, you know, picking up those first three rounds. And of course, if they get this fourth, it could be pretty influential to force them back up to a win. But still, it's not going well for them so far in the first spy round. Very good aggression from UCGL to pick up those first couple of kills. Millwall only left on three players now, but they're going to be stacked towards the correct site as the A main push seems like it's going to be an option here coming out from UCGL. And look at this, Wong actually rotating very preemptively without spotting anything over towards B. Three players over towards A. And UCGL are falling for this bait so perfectly. Smokes are going to be set up. You can see that's just going to be Mantua's doing his. And the rest of them just filing out onto the site very shortly. But Wong, he's got a position and he's got to do something with it. Goes for this first shot. His information has been gathered by UCGL. Reb, he's going to be doing more than gathering information as he picks up a kill to Shank. Prezi with a refrag. Needs to go for a double, but not going to be the case as he gets finished off. And UCGL, they take 12-7.
Like a 19th century man with influenza, that is going to be Millwall falling there, and they do lose that sight. And that's going to be the 12th round going the way of UCGL. Now, they are really relying at this point on Velox to get that chopper gunner cooled in and hopefully take it into the next round. Of course, the map after this is Caspian Border, so I'm really looking forward to that. No AWP on is the key thing here for the CT side. They are going to be having three players in mid with just their rifles, and if they get challenged by Rev, then they could be in a seriously bad spot of bother. But he's gonna be playing over towards the A site with that AVP, so he's just looking, playing these angles nice and slowly. That's the thing I like about what UCGL are doing right now. They're not, you know, they're not getting over aggressive or too big for their boots. They're still well within the realms of what they know they can do, taking it nice and slow, thinking about it tactically. And at this point, it feels like maybe Millwall went into this a little bit too gung-ho, and it has really come back to punish them in that regard. Picking the T side first, trying to be a little bit ballsy, a little bit wacky, a little bit zany, a little bit crazy, and it just hasn't worked out for them right now, and they are paying the price for it subsequently.
But here we go, maybe a bit of convergence over towards the A site here. Thomas going to be holding it off with his teammate Shanked there, and he's looking for some Shank kills, or maybe some rifle kills, that'd probably be more viable. Mansfield's though, heading out of Squeaky here with the support of Hawk, and the flashes are going to come in, thick and fast. Red picks up the first gun to Thomas, but there's an overpeak from Shank, and he will get punished for it. Hawk takes him down, and Mansfield drops Prezi as well, so just Wong and Velox again for this retake. But UCGL, they've secured another round in the bag, not another bag of the round. That wouldn't make sense.
Yeah, no, not at all. I did buy a rather nice new coat today, by the way, Hugo.
You told me in the last match.
Yeah, I know.
You told me.
I know. My life is uneventful. And I will be talking about this for the next 3 months.
So what did you do today, Harry?
I bought a new coat. It's
what
an
else?
Overcoat. It's black. It's long. What else did I do?
Did you buy a coat?
Yeah, I did that. What else? I sort out my stream stuff. If you wanna follow me on Twitter, I'll tweet whenever I'm streaming. Yep. For all of you folks at home watching right now, be sure to follow me on Twitter. Now we have got UCGL here. They've bought up fully once again, going into this, trying to secure their third round in a row. Millwall just crumbling under the pressure here. Very heavy mid presence as Thomas and Shanked push up here into the mid, going for this boost, and it might be a very fruitful endeavor for them as they do go over. But we honestly, Wag, we've been watching it, well, admittedly, with a Molotov, not the best tool of the trade. Good damage done onto him, but not enough. And Shank is just going to be dropping off there, not wanting to take that engagement.
A good lead out on towards the B site. Waggle's going to be leading the charge, and again, still no players actually to challenge just Velux apart from him. He's going to be doing some good work. Picks up two kills, one grabs another one, and instantly from I can't even speak, I don't even know the saying, but they were in a good place and now they're in a very not good place as Prezi's still alive on the site with control of the bomb, and Velux as well to support from CT spawn, but the smoke is going to come in. Hawk will be denying that, and now he just has to take these two single engagements. That's going to be a good call from him. If he does take two 1v1s, he'll be happy. But just not even realizing Prezi's alive on the site, he will get dropped there. And that'll be the round to Millwall.
I feel like we should try the multicultural tricast.
Do it.
Alright, what nationalities are we going for?
Right, Harry. You are three people. You are Corey Dunn, you are the War Owl, and you are generic... British caster.
Oh no, wait. Are you
or
sure?
Do you want to do someone else? Sure? No. You're Corey Dunn, you're Uber Shouts, and you're the War Owl. Go.
Alright, here we go. And we're going to be seeing the CT side. They're opting to stay in mid. We've got Velox boosted up here on the A side. He's going to be watching out, doing whatever he can. Thomas, though, trying to hold down middle all by himself. We have got the rotate coming in from his teammates. Two players over by B. Bomb just kind of hanging back in towards the CT, in towards the T spawn. It's going to be heading out towards A. Yeah, and we're going to be seeing Velox now. It's all going to come down to him. He's in this boost spot. He's going to have to really try to make things come together now with these headshots. The push is going to be on any minute now. Yeah, and we're going to be seeing Velox now. It's all going to come down to him as the flashes do come out onto the side. He's going to be peeking. The boost, though, does kind of... I lost my voice, thank God. Sorry.
Keep going.
That was fun. Yeah, now the push is on. Waggle does manage to pick up one of the Thomas. Gets traded down by Shag. He picks up two. Now it's all down to Rev. And that's going to be Rev going down. That's going to be the ninth round going the way of Millwall Bushwhackers. They do get their first round on the
board. Right, what do you have to say about that round?
Well, you know, when you look at things like... sorry, Alan, wait. Greetings. I, the War Owl, greets you. Yeah, and when you look at things the way that they just went... I can't do it now. I'm going Corey Dunn again. It's one or the other, Hugo. It's one or the other. You can't have them both. Normally I can do them both, but today I can't.
The pressure has gotten to you, and either way, the pressure has certainly not gotten to Millwall as they're managing to pull themselves out from the dirt back into this game. Last two rounds in a row as well, so good play from them at least. UCGL aren't going to be challenging this with these pistols. There should be a double-digit round here, but oh, Rev wants to deny that. Great shot with a Glock to take down Thomas. Days would be proud, and Shanked is going to be shutting down Marcus as well. So one still peaking aggressive with that CZ. Will actually come on top of the engagement, and Waggle and Hawk are going to be the last two alive here in this 2v4. Shanked does drop Hawk, and that's all on the hands of Waggle. Not for long. Wonk finishes that off, and Millwall, they take turn.
Millwall trying to get more rounds on the board. They do manage to take it up to 10. And now at this point, it's all down to UCGL. They're going to be buying up and going into this next round. And there we go. We are going to see a double off setup coming out from Millwall Bushwhackers as they're trying to stay in this game. But it's just not proving fruitful for them right now as they do have 10 rounds on the board. Starting this, you know, very, very weak on the CT side. And we do see as well UCGL, you know, not favoring the T side that much. And they are. I don't even know where that went. That went Irish? Like a little bit, but Scottish, mainly Irish. Scottish. Yeah, sorry, that never normally happens.
Super multicultural.
Yeah, it's so multicultural, we're just blending them together now. Like, look, it's gonna be like, and then over on the B-bomb site, we're gonna be seeing, that's gonna be Rev, along with his compadre. It's probably gonna be Hawk, if I had to guess. And, I was trying to go to Australian, but it just didn't work. I'll just do Uber shouts on me, it'll just be a duo. Hugo, you're fired.
See ya. Stream goes offline because I'm doing the production. You just sit and talk to yourself all night.
Good night, mate. We got Wong. He's going to be over here on that back plat. He's got that AWP beside him. So, you know, he's going to be trying to do what he can. I'm even looking into mid because I have lost mid control now. They did give that up a little while ago. Wong just trying to find a shot. And if Wangle does be peeking out here, he will get dropped. And so we're going to come down to Shank. Holding off this push, the flash does go out into the sights. Now he does fall back into behind Forklift. Wangle ending up with a wonderful headshot there onto Wong. Shanked. Does find Wong. Can he make it two? Wangle makes it two. Can he? No. Wangle's going to make it three. This man is going nuts today. Now it's going to come down as the retake comes in. Prezi and Velox here for the retakes. And they have got an AWP steal on Hawk.
Oh, but Mansa's right behind. He's going to have a great position. Picks up one onto Prezi, and there's still Velox to deal with. He's threw away that. The rule about taking those engagements when you're behind someone or you have two players that are unsuspecting, if one's closer than the other, you always shoot the player that's further away first, and then you shoot the player closer. Because one... no, there's only one reason. Because obviously it's harder to hit the player further away, so you want to get the free kill on the further away player and then take the fair engagement on the closer player because you have a way bigger chance of winning. Or just sneak up, go for the knife, and then shoot the second player. Yeah. But
14-10 currently, and we are going to be seeing UCGL trying to close out this second map, but Wong is not ready to let that happen just yet, as he does get a wonderful shot there onto Mansworth to put it into a 4 versus 5 very early on in the round.
Definitely a good start here, because of course I don't want to allow UCGL to pick up 15 and get to that ever needed match point, because of course when you get to that match point, the other team has no buffer, they can't lose a round, they can't mess up their economy, they have to invest correctly into the stocks and shares, they need a good bank, and UCGL, they're very, very close to getting that 15th. Now onto the site here. Spat's already going to be picking up that first kill. It's a nice lead. Look at this boost over the smoke actually coming out from Rev. He's going to be up on top of the his teammate there. And they just work their way out onto the A site, but it's not going too well. Prezi and Shanked both picking up kills. Waggle will refrag. And look at that body falling from the sky. There's still Prezi alive on the site. They haven't taken him down. They're still pushing him very preemptively. And it's not going to go too well. Thomas and Prezi will sweep things up and take 11.
Yeah, you know, the 11th round on the board for Millwall. They still have a chance, of course, to catching up to UCGL, which they could do, seeing as they have put them onto a very, very bad situation. Now, we will be seeing what looks to be an eco coming out from UCGL here. So, this is Millwall's chance to take it to 14-12. And at that point, you know, they are within the danger zone of, you know, taking this maybe to overtime, which I would say would not be a bad situation for Millwall to be in.
Carl says in chat, the further one was out of cover and was off the cover, out of position towards Carl, making it an easier trade for his team if Mansell were to fail. But the issue was with that is the players inside of the site, the defending players, the rest of the terrorists were on the site. They had the smokes down. They weren't going to be over-peaking to take those players out on Carl. They wouldn't be challenging because they weren't in a position to trade. They were deep on the site. So they wouldn't have been able to trade in that position anyway. But that would be a good argument if they were in a good position to trade. But either way, back into the game, and this round is going again like it's going to Millwall. Thomas is going to clear things up 12-14. This is extremely close. But Harry's going AFK apparently, and as we go into the 27th round here, two players already remain for UCGL. Just Spat and Waggle. This looks like a possible another round to Millwall, because they can just play the trade game down to the last man and still be two men ahead of this, so they shouldn't have too much of an issue if they do decide to go for some challenging. But of course they want to have, obviously, if one player peeks out into mid and takes his fight, say Thomas, you know, over towards A, they want to be sure that they have a player ready to trade this engagement, because they obviously don't want to be losing players and turning it into a 2v2 or a 2v3. Because then UCGL will be able to take advantage of that, and it will soon favour them, so they can pick up the last few rounds, the last few kills. But either way, Millwall playing it correctly, not going to be over peeking shanked, maybe coming into combat. I really don't agree with this if he does go for the peek there. An information peek like this is fine, of course, but pushing aggressively down to middle, that was a fine peek, but if he pushed aggressively down to middle, it would be a bit questionable, because obviously he wouldn't be able to get many kills with that long range, with that close range Mag 7.
And I couldn't agree more. That's going to be Bong going down over on B. Velox does find that kill on a span. Now he does try to challenge Wang. I'm not sure if I agree with these kind of peaks as he does go down. And now that bomb is going to be there, but the rotate is already come in. There is going to be backup in CT in this form of Shank, who's got that Mag 7 looking for that, I believe it's like $1,200 kill reward or $800. I can't remember. Anyway. Bomb now on Waggle, 16 seconds left. That time is ticking down. Molotov does come in just to delay that plant a little bit more. He's going to be planting very, very close to the flames, but not getting burnt. What a guy. Slightly fire resistant as well, and that's going to be Shanks picking up that kill with the Mag 7. They do get the plant there. That's going to be plenty of money then for them in that next round, which they will need desperately if they understand any chance of buying. Of course, if they do eco on this next round, then, it stands a really good chance of going to 14-14.
Yeah, very lucky for Waggle there, not getting caught out in the Molotov. Obviously, if that Molotov landed on him, he'd be cooked like a freshly cooked buffet. But, of course, plays it very well, just escapes that one in the round, of course, goes to Millwall on that retake.
Right, yeah, then we are now going into the next round, and we are going to be seeing a very heavy A presence there. That smoke's just going to be stopping that push through any potential of any life coming from that. Like a vasectomy, almost, actually, you could say. Now, Flash going out onto the site, enemy pushing out. Molotov does go down, and this is it. The push is on. Mansman finds one under Prezi. Spat finds one under Shanked, and now this site's already completely under their control. And that's going to be bomb getting planted. Still plenty of time left on that clock, and Wong, Velox, and Thomas in for the retake now.
Yep, this is going to be a difficult one. They're going to have to come into this fast, because obviously time is ticking away in the afterpond, so UCG are looking very good. One picks up one onto Mansur's, and there's still going to be some challenge. Rev takes another, and he takes two as well. He's shutting them down, and Thomas, he's going to get finished off. Rev takes a 3k to save UCG in the most important round of the match so far. Okay, back into the game, 29 rounds, so two off the end, and UCGL, they're going to be storming out in towards middle. This is very, very aggressive, so much presence, and Thomas is going to be shutting down that first kill. But one, almost going for that shot off, misses the one of the Hawk there. They really need a further advantage. Millwall are doing very well on a 5v4 already, but they're not exactly favouring, of course, so they do have two pistols. Thomas shuts down Waggle, though, and they're going to be rotating back out of that area. You see GL still trying to work out into something, though. Of course, playing very slow at the moment. Want to try and converge into something very fast. And Wong, he's going to find that lovely headshot onto Hawk. What a shot there. And you can see Spat and Vape are going to be last two alive. I don't know what's so funny here.
Oh, I don't know.
Stop, like... Harry. Stop. I'm trying to concentrate, okay? Spat, either way, working his way out onto the A site. Nate going down. Good bit of damage there, at least. Millwall are getting a complete shutdown this round. And there we go. Rev shutting down Wong. The fast peak, almost as fast as Disney Pixar's Cars. But right now, it's going very well for Millwall, despite losing that player on Wong.
Yeah, what an apt example there, Hugo. And 15-13, UCGL, they do need this in order to take it. And take it, you know, to the third map, which is going to be Dust 2, like we said. They're going to be heading over towards that B site. And it is all or nothing right now. Here it is, the push is going to be coming on, but smoke only just going down. 10 seconds left, they need to start pushing out. Thomas does find one. And that's going to be Velox there, getting that final headshot on the span. 15-14 with a good chance of overtime now. And, you know, as we approach what is, you know, the climax of this event, the you know, it's all amounted to this final round right now. This does decide the fate of the game, and like we said, this is the climax. Similar to Rotic Strangulation here, as we are going to see the crowd holding with bated breath. Five of the UCGR players, four of them over towards B, one just waggle all by himself, waggling around in the wind, ready to kind of do the fake onto A.
This is going to be a very fast play from UCGO. Millwall are going to hold this off with good effectiveness. Of course, these three pistols are going to be a bit of an issue here for the terrorist side, and I'm sure these CTs will be able to mop this up and bring this one to overtime. That's got to be true. Thomas and Velox, both good positions. Thomas doesn't have head armor, so it's maybe a bit of an issue up against these players. Like the P250s, Attack 9s in play as well. Wackle's going to peek out. Flash goes in. Thomas is full white. Now the push is underway. But they haven't even spotted him. He goes for the shot. Picks up that kill. Well, full blind. Wackle will fall. And Rev shuts him down now. So Velox going to be alive on the site. Picks up one. Spat will go down. Prezi, well, dropping into the site, takes down Rev. And now it's all on Mansus as he takes one kill onto Wong.
Ants was here, just hiding in a corner, doing what he does best. It's going to start to get shot at through the wall, but not going to phase him whatsoever. Does have that P250. And that's going to be it.
Yep, these flashes are just going to be brutal. There's no way he's going to be able to get out of this. I'm sure we'll be going to overtime after this. I'd like to see the crazy clutch, but realistically, I don't think that's going to be the case. And Velox, he's going to shut him down. Mill will bring this back from a 11-4 scoreline all the way to 15-15 here, going into overtime. Here we go, 10 seconds, or we'll be going back into overtime. Of course, this is MR3 overtime, if I'm correct. So that's, I think, 10k and three rounds on either side. And off we go into the pistol round. Now, obviously, I'm joking, the buy round here. MR3 overtime, they have $10,000 each to spend. Got to value their economy, but two warps already on the T side. They clearly are valuing their economy on UCGL. Here we go. Just a normal default coming out from the T side. Hey, this two warps, I really don't agree with this early on in the game.
Yeah, no, I mean, definitely not. Quite a risky buy coming out from UCGL. Picking up those two warps on Hawk and Rev, although if there were two players I would give two warps to, it would be these two right now as we stand. 15-15 is going to be MR3 overtime, like you said, and it all comes down in this. Here we go. First round of the overtime. Of course, if UCGL use this, it's going to be a very, very costly round for them because they have bought these two warps, and that could potentially, you know, do them some harm in the long run if they start to run out of money in overtime.
Oh, but almost getting that wallbang there. I think he may have hit it. No, Wong was actually on the site, just surviving that one. Rev trying to hit that shot there, and we can see UCGL getting ready to converge onto this A site, but the bomb isn't in their hand, so they're obviously just waiting on this pick right now before they actually fully commit to this. Of course, you are going to want to watch out. Don't want to just rush straight onto a site without any bomb in tow. What is so funny, Harry? I must have missed something, but either way, oh, look at this boost. Wong's going to be up on the site here. Rev, you're making me laugh now, and I don't know what to do. Oh, dude, this has been a long day.
It was just the way that, like, one of the players, they just, like, looked away from each other right at the last minute, and it made me laugh so much just thinking about.
But either way, Wong going to be alive on the site. Picked up two kills already, going for the aces. UCGL committing to the site, though. Wong will finally go down. Waggle's going to shut him down there. And now the push onto the A site comes into play. Hawk is going to be also alive, but Prezi is going to be able to finish him off. Shanked with a 2k there. Shanked is actually pretty good. Almost as good as Norbit, because of course Norbit was a pretty good film.
Yeah, no, I couldn't agree more. Truly inspirational. Almost as good as Adam Sandler's Click. Now as we go into this next round, 15-16, second round in Millwall. They do manage to take the first round, of course, and that's going to be huge because look at this, they're already on a 4-spy. UCGL, they have got that Tech 9. Now, things right now are just going in a little bit of a cock jam for them. Not what they want, not what they plan whatsoever. You know, not looking good. And similar to when, you know, the cock does get jammed sometimes, it's going to be the five of them now over towards B. And they're just waiting out this smoke in order before they get onto the site there. They're probably going to be throwing some smokes of their own over into the site. You have a few flashes on them as well. It is looking like it's going to be a fast push though, because we have got this Tech 9 on Hawk, and I can't help but feel like they're not going to want to take this slowly. Fast has worked in the past though, so that's anything to go by. This should be all good.
Fast has worked in the past, I like that one. But still, Millwall holding this off. Double Molly goes out, and UCGL, they're getting ready to push on straight into the spray down there. Thomas, he picks up two kills, a lot of damage as well, and Prezi will grab the third one. And now Mansfield, he's going to answer back onto Thomas getting that kill, but there's still only two more terrorists left, and Hawk, he's going to be shut down, leaving just Mansfield alone over in the vent area, just dropping in one by one, and Shank's going to find that headshot, securing the round for Millwall. With 17 to 15, we go into the final round of the half here in the favour of Millwall. They wanted to pick up three in a row, but UCGL, they aren't on a great buy here for this final round. But Wong with this auto snap, it's just so much fun to see. He's just going to spam through the wall. There's no one there for the UCGL.
Yeah, indeed, 15-17, and Millwall suddenly back on top of things. They do have two rounds out of the three they're going to need, and if they manage to secure all three, then they only need to win one in order to take this 2-0. And I can't help but feel like UCGL's morale must be crushed at this point, in, you know, considering how well they started this off.
But it appears that UCGL have no money, and I think it's clear why UCGL have no money at this point. I think it's because they spent all their money on a subscription-based service that subscribes your phone to receive animal facts. That's clearly what they spent all their money on their phone contract. So they aren't able to afford all these rifles. Three pistols on the board, and a Waggle does have this AK-47 as well, but he's 4 HP, so the animal facts may not be helping them too much for UCGL. They're going to be trying to rush out. Wong holding this down, though. Great shot to Mantle. Still three players alive for UCGL. He's trying to finish one off. Warbang's coming in, but he's not going to be hitting anything. We've got to watch out. The Rev is close in the smoke. We'll be able to hit this shot if he does give away some more traces. And just rushing out onto the A site. Velox is going to be rotating in as well. And Shank going to be doing some damage here. He will be dropped though. And oh, there's still Thomas on the site. Waggle is going to get picked up by Thomas as well, who takes a double kill. And that'll be 18-15. The first half of overtime concluded. Millwall, they need one more round to secure this third place victory.
Yeah, very, very intense. And Millwall so close to the line right now. And just, you know, they can almost taste it, they can smell it, it's on their breath, and UCGL must just be crushed at this point. They were so close, yet so far, only one more round needed for Millwall, and the best that UCGL can look for at this point is for, you know, a second overtime.
And I don't think that's really going to be likely, to be perfectly honest.
Yeah, no. Couldn't agree more. I mean, at this point, their morale must be crushed, even more than their economy. So, you know, it is going to be 15-18, and we're just going to be going into this any minute now. I'm sure we're just waiting for this. Waiting be crushed at this point. Like a group of it was so guns or something like that, and there we go. We are going into this. Is I think we're going to be seeing both teams readying up now.
Stream just accidentally playing in the background, that's a bit awkward. But either way, yeah, readying up on the Hawk side. We're just waiting for Millwall to ready up. I'm not sure why they're taking so much time, because of course, you know, they've already got 18-15. But to be fair, they do need a good, you know, first round, because obviously they only got four rounds on the T side anyway. So it may be a bit of a struggle. They want to sort out a good strategy for the first round, and they're obviously discussing that just now so they can work out what the hell they're going to do, because they've got to pull off something pretty phenomenal, considering they only got 4 out of 15 last time.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. And let's not forget, I mean, if Millwall do this, of course, this means that they're going to be finishing in third place, which, Hugo, how much money does that mean that they're going to be taking
home?
Third
place is £450.
Exactly. And, you know, UCGL, they've done a phenomenal job. They didn't even qualify for this event. They did get invited afterwards when there was a scheduling error that prevented, I believe it was
Ufrag
from playing. And
but either way,
result.
£200 for UCGL, well. It's very impressive at least getting into the top four. Maybe eventually they'll think of a strat.
Yeah,
you know, it would be really funny if they spent all this time wasting time just like, you know, doing whatever, sorting out a strat, and then they just full on rush B in the first round.
I mean, that's what I always get told to do whenever I play MM.
So. Yeah, Vladimir is always Vladimir and Nikolai, always there with the good advice. But either way, we're going to be slam dunking our way right into this first round here of the second half of overtime. UCGL versus Millwall Bushwhackers. And may possibly be one of the last rounds here as Millwall are on match point to clean this one up with a 19-15 scoreline. If they can, of course. But, you know, anything can happen right now. And we are going to see UCGL with a double up as well back on the CT side. So they tried it on T and CT. Didn't work on T. Maybe it will work on CT. Wong is also going to have a single up here for the CT. He's just trying to get some shots off into mid. But the nade, that's going to be a good pot. Great damage there onto Spatenhawk. Putting them down quite low HP. And we will be seeing a little bit of a boost up towards the top of middle here. And oh, Hawk could get some serious work. LeBron will be proud at this point. He's going to be ready for this. And, oh, no, he's going to get shut down by Velox. Slam dunked right in the head there, and Hawk's going to fall there. So already the advantage going to Millwall. And it's not like they need it, of course. 18-15 is already a pretty dominating scoreline. And we're going to see...
Yeah, no, really I do agree. Sorry, 18-15, not where UCGL want to be. Potentially, you know, this could be it. This could be them going home. And they really need to hold on to this at this point. And they're already one man down. And, you know, as the A push looks like it's about to come into fruition, you only have, well, to be fair, you do have three UCGL players here. So, you know, they have read this situation well, in spite of losing a player early on.
Smokes are being set up outside of the A site. They're bomb as well. So they've got all five players committed to this A site. One over in mid to go for this boost. So they definitely are going for the A take right now. That's, obvious. And oh, look at the double kill. What a slam dunk there by Mansus. Picks up 2-1, gets the trade kill. So that's a ball in the hole there for him. And the refrag comes out by Wackle. He's also dunking his way to the final. And Shanked will get a reverse kill back onto him, spinning round and potting that as well. Even just Prezi and Shanked are last two alive in this 2-1 as Prezi takes down Spat. All down to Wackle now. He's going to have to get a real ball in the hole to secure this round. But he does land that first ball. Still going to get the 360 jump shot. And Prezi, he's going to be alone here. He has to rush him. There's no way Waggle's going to be able to get out alive. And Prezi, he goes for the shot, but there's no time. Waggle gets away 15 HP. And that's going to be the round there to UCGL. By the skin of his teeth, he escapes out of main. And 16-18 will be the score for now.
Yeah, so close there. Waggle just managing to make it around the corner. Just barely getting out of Prezi's grasp. And then that's going to lock in the 16th round. And suddenly, you know, they are once again posing a major threat here to Millwall Bushwhackers. Now we're going to be seeing Wong buying up that AWP. And he's going to be taking it. He's going to be heading... Oh, hello, Jesus Christ. Welcome to the future, kids. We are here.
But Hawk's AFK. So that's definitely not good on this round.
Yeah, no, not at all. I mean... Hawk being FK, probably just dealing with that far fetish he has going on at home. I'm unsure. He is a man who loves the gas. I mean, that's just all I can tell at this point. Manswizzo, he's going to be looking into way main, trying his hardest to land the shot. Hawk, will he come back? He's still ingesting and he's going to be timing out now. And this is the round you don't want that to be happening on, of course. Because, I mean, fairly essential. I mean, unsure if this is going to count, but like, wouldn't surprise me as a result of that, you know. This is basically going to be the thing that loses them the game, sadly.
They weren't able to call in a pause in time, and that's going to be the downfall of them. You can see just Rev and Spat, last two alive here, and it's just going to be Millwall holding onto the site here. Bomb will be going down. It should be a definite difficult retake here in this situation. Not sure if there's going to be time for it. And Rev waiting for Spat to join him up in A main. Now they're finally going to make their way into the site here. First kill does come out in the favour of Spat. Shanked will be dropped. Prezi has to get a double kill to come out of this one. And now he's going to get the first one. Dropping Rev and Spat. Oh no, Spat's going to choke it. Prezi still going to be going for the peak here. No nades left on him. So he's got not a lot of time. 10 seconds left on the bomb. Spat's going to be sticking it. Prez is just going to be running around the corner. And, oh, no. I'm not sure what Spat was thinking or drinking. Must have been out of season eggnog because he just got ruined. And 19-16 is going to be the score there for Millwall Bushwhackers, securing that third place and the £450 to come with it. UCGL, commiserations to them. They'll only be taking £200 home. But it's still a significant amount of money. But either way, that's going to be the game there. Best of three, ending in 2-0 in the favour of the Millwall Bushwhackers.